My name is Komal Dadlani. I'm also known as Komi Yogi. I'm a Hatha Yoga instructor, and I've teamed up with UBCK to share with you some of the yoga practices and some of the asanas, the breathing exercises that I have used to help myself in my journey with lupus for the past 20 years. Today we're going to do a very stretchy, relaxing session focused on how to breathe better. Breathing better and more deeply are key to promote the relaxation response of our nervous system, which in turn helps us to reduce overall inflammation throughout our body. We're going to start with a short mantra, just to tune into the practice, to tune into this moment of us connecting to our body. And then we will carry on with our postures and breathing exercises. Slowly, we're going to start by taking our arms behind our body, interlacing our fingers, squeezing the shoulder blades in, and raising our arms off our back. Closing our eyes, let's take our attention to our abdomen and graduate our breath to a count of two. Inhaling two, one. Exhaling two and one, sitting with our back straight. If you have a cushion to sit on like I am doing right now, then that's even better. But otherwise, you can just remain sitting on the ground. We're now going to let go of our hands and do the same thing, but stretching our arms up to the sky or the ceiling, interlacing our fingers, extending throughout our elbows, reaching as high as we can and trying to keep our arms and our ears closely together. If it is not possible to have the arms fully straight, that's okay. Try to get your arms with your ears. And now we're going to stretch the arms forward, interlacing the fingers again. And slowly we're going to relax our arms. I'm just going to sit sideways so that you can see how I'm breathing better. And if you have a strap at home, you might find it helpful to have one with you now. So if you notice, when I sit towards the front edge of my cushion. You can also use a pillow or any kind of sofa cushion that you have at home. But you should always sit towards the front edge of it rather than sitting towards the back. So we use the cushion not to cushion our hips, but to provide us the necessary height so that we can then slide forward and create a little bit of a diagonal angle towards the ground so that our knees are more comfortably touching the mat as well. So we're going to repeat what we did earlier. We start by rolling our shoulders up, down, squeezing our shoulder blades, interlacing our fingers and we stretch. Now some of you might find it a little bit difficult to fully straighten the arms. If you're finding that your upper back is quite tight and you can only stretch the arms halfway, this is where you can use the strap. You can pull the strap in this manner. And then you can give yourself as much distance with the strap as you need in order for you to be able to fully extend throughout your elbows. It's really important that you do this exercise while fully extending the arms. And now take your attention back to your abdomen. Breathing deeply. And you can now take your attention back to your abdomen and focus on expanding the abdomen with every inhalation. Try to graduate your breath to a count of three. Inhaling three, two, and one. Exhaling three, two, and one. Inhaling wrap, and we're going to rest our left hand onto our right leg. Roll the right shoulder up, down, squeeze the shoulder blades, and push our left hand against our right thigh to look over the shoulder. Try your very best to have your shoulders stacking right on top of your hips as well. Now watch your breath. You're going to keep breathing abdominally, inhaling abdomen. Exhaling, rolling the shoulder and looking over. Inhaling, two, one. Exhaling, two, and one. Inhaling, expanding. Exhaling, looking over. We do the same thing on the other side. So now we're going to take our right hand onto our left leg. And now roll the left shoulder up and down. Notice how the arm is straight behind you. And we're now pushing the right leg against the left thigh to rotate and look over the shoulder. We push the right hand against the left eye a little more. And then slowly we return back to the center. Okay, one more time. Arms up to the sky or the ceiling. Fully extend throughout your elbows. Reach up. And as you exhale, relax the arms alongside your body. Bring your hands onto your abdomen, and we're just going to practice our abdominal breathing so that we know how to breathe throughout the rest of our session. So both hands are now placed onto our abdomen. And as you inhale, you want to feel that the abdomen expands out into your palms, like this. I hope that you can see the movement of my abdomen as I'm expanding. Avoid what would look like this. Okay, most of us, when we take a deep breath, we focus too much on breathing up into the chest. When we're doing abdominal breathing, we want to relax the chest and focus on expanding the abdomen. So you notice there's barely any movement on my chest and on my shoulders. It's all at the level of my abdomen. And I exhale, and I exhale, my abdomen relaxes back in towards my body. I inhale abdomen, and I exhale, the abdomen deflates and relaxes back in towards my body, as opposed to taking a deep breath into my chest. Okay, notice the difference? You don't want to be doing that. You want to always be breathing at the level of your abdomen. This helps you. This gives the diaphragm a lot more range of movement, which also contributes to the relaxation of the nervous system. Very important for you to be breathing from your abdomen, not just throughout your yoga practice, but throughout the day as well. And watch yourself when you're driving, when you're cooking, when you're doing the cleaning. Very important for you to be breathing from your abdomen. And you're going to remember this abdominal breathing for the rest of our practice. Really important for us to keep breathing this way. And we're now going to sit onto our heels, separating our heels, mat width. And if you struggle to sit all the way down, so some of you might find it a little bit difficult to sit all the way down, you can cover it if you go all the way down. And you can take a blanket. I only have an extra yoga mat here, but you can take a blanket and you can fold it into this thick height, like this, or thicker if you need it to be thicker. You place it underneath onto your heels, and that will give you the height that you need to cushion yourself up and to be able to properly sit onto your heels. It might be you need even more height, and you can maybe even use a pillow for that. And you can sit on top of the pillow like this, okay? Use a blanket, a pillow, a cushion, and from there we're going to stretch our arms forward and the length of forehead down to the ground. Now,
if the forehead doesn't touch the ground completely, then you can place both hands into fists and snap one fist on top of the other and allow the forehead down into your fist. Very important for us to breathe from our abdomen. Inhaling up and expand towards the ground. Exhaling up and the face and the left foot. I'm going to give you a few moments of silence for you to practice here. Always focusing on expanding the abdomen. Slowly, we're going to bring our hands towards our chest, press into the hands,
and slowly sit back up onto our heels. Now remember, if you're not able to sit fully onto your heels, then you have the option to place a cushion or to place a blanket. Make it as thick as you need to, so that you can sit comfortably. Important that you are sitting onto your hips rather than you coming off them and stretching forward. It doesn't do much for you, okay? So you do need to find something to cushion yourself up and fully sit onto the surface. We're going to try the same thing, but now we are going to intentionally place the cushion. If you have a bolster, then you can use a bolster. You can place a bolster or a long pillow from your bed, from your bedroom. Long pillow from the bedroom. We're going to place the bolster or the pillow close to our body. Okay, I'm going to remove this because I don't need it. Okay, but you can keep on. If your hips are not touching your heels, then you should keep it with you. And we're going to stretch ourselves forward. Ideally, the cushion is supporting our abdomen, and we're just going to rotate our head to one side and hug our cushion, hug our bolster with our arms. And we want to feel the abdomen expanding out towards the bolster. Slowly, we lift our head and rotate our head to the other side. And one more time, we'll rotate towards the left. Check that you are expanding the abdomen out towards your cushion or bolster, and not so much breathing into the chest. So you are helping your diaphragm to have a larger range of motion, and you're also simultaneously massaging your abdomen with your cushion. Every time you exhale, you can think of relaxing your hips a little closer to the ground, a little closer to the hips. To the heels, sorry. Okay, now very slowly, we're going to move the bolster to the side. Bring our legs together. Stand onto our hands and knees. Stand onto our hands and knees. Okay, so hands are underneath the shoulders, knees are underneath the hips.
And we're going to push deeply into our hands to round our back up into our cat stretch. Relaxing the ears in between the arms. So the arms are very much active in this posture. We are pushing down into our hands. It's good. We're trying to round it back up to the sky as much as you can. But your head and your face are sitting. And now we're going to do the opposite. We're going to send our hips up, take our chin up, raise your breath on the palm of the top. And once again, we're going to come back into cat pose, so pressing down into our hands. Rounding your back up, letting the hip drop in between the arms. And back into cow pose. Hips up, chin up. Shoulders are away from the ears, avoid this. So no hunching, shoulders are raising, your ears are pressing into the hands, hips off. Back neutral, and we're now going to thread the right arm underneath the left arm. We try to stretch the arm as far out to the side as possible until our shoulder and our ear can rest onto the ground. If this is too much for you, and you can use your pillow or you can use your blanket again. So this is a blanket. And you can place your blanket first on your side. Extend the arm out and then relax the shoulder and the head onto the blanket and stretch so that I don't go too deep. Okay? I do recommend you try as much as you can to fully extend and drop the shoulder and the head down to the ground. Now return your attention back to your abdominal breathing. Always looking to expand your abdomen as you inhale. And check that you're not breathing into the chest. And stop. And let's do the same thing on the other side. So now you're going to flat your left arm to the side. You flat, 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 shoulder down, left ear down, head down. Going back to the center. Okay, let's now sit onto the ground. We're going to stretch our left leg forward and pull the right foot in towards the left inner thigh. So, very helpful for you to have your strap here again, using that one. Okay, fully extend the leg forward, flex the foot. This means flex the face. We want to always keep the toes looking up rather than flopping. So, flex, have your strap next to you. Stretch your arms up, arms and ears together. Make yourself as tall as possible. Really grow yourself from the base of your seat. Reach up. And as you exhale, reach forward, keeping your ears in between your arms, keep your toe forward. When you cannot go further, that's when you drop your arms down wherever they can get to. Never mind if your hands are resting now on your thigh or on your shin. Just make sure that you reach as far forward as you're able to, and then you can relax your hands down wherever they get to. You do not have to touch your toes, okay? Avoid bending the leg in order to grab hold of your toes. Make sure that the leg stays completely stretched out. And if you want, you can also use a strap here. And then the strap will just remind you to keep the foot flexed at all times. And keep yourself facing forward, okay? Now we close our eyes, we're going to take our attention back to our abdomen, and we breathe deeply. Inhale, 3, 2, 1, always looking to expand the belly as we inhale. Exhale, 3, 2, 1. inhalation, look straight ahead.
Sit up straight and we're gonna switch sides. Okay, so we're gonna take our right leg forward, left foot in towards the right inner thigh. Our foot is flexed, both arms closing up again. We reach up, extend from the base of our seat. And with the exhalation, we go forward, forward, interlocking arms, moving further, and drop. If you notice, one of my shoulders tends to sit up to stay higher than the other ones, so we just try to level the shoulders a little bit more. Shoulders are the same level. So my hands reach quite comfortably to my foot, but remember, it doesn't have to be this way. You can also use a strap. Remind yourself to keep your feet flat. You can just rest your hands here while you're inside your shin. What's really important is for the foot to stay flexed. Okay? Abdominal breathing. Inhale. Breathe. 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 Exhale. Breathe. 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 Inhale. Breathe. For the next inhalation, we step the hands forward and up. And now we're going to do fascia uttanasana. We're going to stretch both legs forward, feet stay flexed, both feet are now facing up to the ceiling, to the sky. Arms up, reach up. Grow from the base of your seat. Now as you exhale, you are moving up and forward simultaneously. Notice how the ears remain between the arms, keep reaching forward. When you cannot go further anymore, you drop the arms down. Gravity good. Soften the elbows, the posture comes from the hips, not the arms. Soften the elbows, soften the arms. Take your attention to your hips. Think, I want to breathe from my hips. And even if you don't feel anything happening externally, just focus on the inner sensation of the posture. Sometimes you go deeper internally in terms of the sensation of the posture rather than there being a visual change in the external. Focus on how it feels rather than how it looks. Abdominal breathing. Inhale. Three. Two. One, exhale, three, two, one. Count it to yourself. Count the breathing. With inhalation, reach forward with your arms. Keep reaching forward, forward, up. Try to sit up, extend, drop your elbows. Keep yourself tall. Stack your shoulder on top of your hip. Feet flexed, toes up. With strength. Keep holding your feet flexed. Reach up a little more. A little more. And then slowly relax your arms down to the ground. And this time, we're going to bend our legs. We're going to separate our feet a little bit wider than perfect. And then slowly we lie our body down to the mat. And we're going to come into Sukha Baddha-Nidasana. Sukha Baddha-Nidasana. Which means the feet have to be a little bit wider than your hips. Arms
palms are resting alongside your body. You press down into the hips. And as you press down, we want to really squeeze our glutes. Really squeeze. Interlace our arms underneath. Squeeze the shoulder blades. And fully press into the heels so that our hips stay high up. Notice my abdominal breathing. Abdomen rises as we inhale. So if you are not able to interlace your arms, or if you're not able to fully extend, then you can once again
use your strap.
You can hold the posture with your strap. You give your strap as much length as needed so that you're fully able to extend the arms, which is very important. Do not fall into this, okay, where you are interlacing and bending the arms and then attempt to extend. Just give yourself a strap and give it as much length as you need in order to fully stretch throughout the elbows. Abdominal breathing. Slowly just relax up and to the ground. We're going to walk our feet towards the edges of our mat and drop our knees in towards each other. Just rest your hands down here on each other. Okay, let's repeat that one more time. So, feet a little wider than the width. Grab the little strap, or if you're going with a strap, then you're just interlacing your fingers underneath, squeezing the glutes, pressing deeply into the glutes, sorry, into the heels, squeezing the glutes, extending throughout the elbows. Large abdominal breath. Very important for you to observe how just at the moment of exhalation your body tends to relax and the hips tend to drop a little bit. So when you're exhaling, just remain aware. And as you are exhaling, remain aware to keep the hips up high. To stay strong at your heels. And let's relax. We're going to repeat that one more time. Okay, so first walk your feet out to the edges of the mat. Drop your knees in towards each other. Just one more repetition before you rest. Okay, one last time. Feet a little wider than the foot. Press down into the heels, into the legs, the fingers underneath your body. Squeeze the buttocks. Remember to catch hold of the strap here if you need to, in order to fully extend your elbows. Large abdominal breath. And this last time, let's see if maybe we can tap our heels with our fingertips or maybe grab our heels fully. Watch out with your knees, okay? Just make sure that it doesn't create a discomfort in the knees. And slowly relax. Relax your hands into your abdomen. Hug your thighs and in towards your chest. Extending your abdomen in towards your thighs as you breathe. And then slowly roll yourself to one side, roll yourself to the right. And just right past you, to your right hand.
back into Sukhasana. I hope you feel a lot better after your practice. Do let us know. Do let me know that it is okay. Know as well. You can find me on Instagram at Komi_Yogi. And I have a lot more resources for you if you want to dive a little deeper into the journey of yoga. Or you can also find me on Facebook at Komal. Thank you so much.